And now to coal and the challenges of cleaning up old mines. With some coal companies in bankruptcy, the money needed to pay for cleanup isn't always available. Public media's Inside Energy and the Allegheny Front teamed up to report from two of the country's largest coal-producing states. Leigh Paterson takes us first to western Pennsylvania.
It's a nice day for a walk in the woods, but this is not a hiking trail.
This site is known as the Fredericktown Refuse Pile. Some people call it the Black Dog Hollow Refuse Pile as well.
A coal refuse pile made up of rocks and low-quality coal.
And then the reject material was just trammed and then conveyored up the hill and dumped on this giant pile and left.
That was over 70 years ago. The coal mine nearby changed hands as companies went bankrupt. Now, the pile's a hazard. There are hundreds of sites like this one in Pennsylvania, and there are tens of thousands of abandoned mine sites scattered across the country.
They can't catch on fire. This particular pile is not burning that we are aware of, but many of these do catch on fire.
Like this one in Einan, Pennsylvania, that was put out in 2015. Cavazza once fell into a burning pile himself while investigating a fire years ago.
It was very scary. It was like walking onto a trap door and having somebody pull the string because you just dropped. And I was in over my head in a hole, and it was smoke all around me.
Not all problems with abandoned mine sites are straight out of an action movie, but they're still significant. When it rains, these coal refuse piles can discharge some nasty stuff. This so-called acid mine drainage can contaminate streams and sometimes even impact the local water supply. Homeowners like the ones who live around this pile deal with pipes and sewers that get clogged with runoff.
So it's a big maintenance issue for the township.
Cavazza, as the head of the bureau that deals directly with abandoned mine remediation, wants these piles cleaned up. But it's expensive, and the money to do the cleanup is tight. A lot of it comes from something called the Abandoned Mine Land Fund, or AML.
The fund is generated by the active mining industry, and the country is beginning to move away from coal as a primary source for electricity generation.
And with coal production at its lowest level in 30 years, there's simply less money coming in. In Pennsylvania alone, AML funding has dropped by over 25% since 2013. In Wyoming, the worry is about future cleanup costs.
How thick is that seam right there?
35 feet thick.
These pits are huge and are generally filled in as mining operations progress.
The area that you see mining right here will look like this in approximately 2 years.
This green grassy area right next to the mine was a mine itself just a few years ago. It has since been filled in and reseeded as part of the complicated, lengthy cleanup process known as reclamation.
For part of the leasing process, before any mining begins, mines are required to have a reclamation plan.
And something called reclamation bonding.
That's a guarantee, an insurance, that we will accomplish the reclamation that's outlined as part of that lease.
So basically, a payment to make sure future mine cleanup gets done.
Regulations in some states allow coal producers to self-bond, which means companies promise to pay for cleanup based on their financial strength. The problem comes when those companies become financially shaky and those cleanup costs get tied up in bankruptcy court. In Wyoming, over the course of this year, we're talking about over $1 billion.
All of course before digital.
Pat Sweeney has been working on Western land issues for decades and even lobbied for the 1977 federal law that regulates coal mine cleanup. He puts this problem into perspective.
Remember, the circumstances were so different then, too, because you had viable companies that at the time no one ever thought there might be companies going bankrupt. No one thought, you know, in some respects, that there would be a change in energy policy.
Cloud Peak Energy, the coal company that took us on the reclamation tour, is not one of the companies in bankruptcy and is moving away from the practice of self-bonding. But with some of the largest coal companies in the country working out reclamation details during and after bankruptcy, the future of cleanup is unclear. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Leigh Paterson.
We'll be back with an excerpt of a 1985 interview with Fidel Castro by our own Robert McNeil. But first, take a moment to hear from your local PBS station. It's a chance to offer your support, which helps keep programs like ours on the air.